In today's measurement landscape, businesses need to navigate new challenges to understand the complex, multi-platform journeys of their customers, all while prioritizing user privacy. With Google Analytics, you can address these evolving measurement standards and help your business succeed. Google Analytics has the flexibility to measure many different kinds of data, delivering a strong analytics experience that's designed for the future. It allows businesses to see unified user journeys across their websites and apps, uses Google's machine learning technology to surface and predict new insights, and most importantly, it's built to keep up with the changing ecosystem. Let's look at some key components of Google Analytics that allow you to measure unified user journeys across websites and apps while also keeping up with the evolving privacy landscape. We'll start with the data controls and look at the data deletion tool. Google Analytics helps businesses continue to respect customer consent and keep up with evolving industry regulations using enhanced property and user-level data controls combined with updated data collection practices. The data deletion tool lets you directly take action on data deletion requests. So, if you need to delete data from the analytics servers for any reason, you can create a data deletion request to issue a request for its removal with just a few clicks. For example, let's say you're sending through URLs using a custom event and are unintentionally sending some personally identifiable information contained in those URLs. You could use data deletion to remove the parameters containing that information from that custom event. Let's walk through those steps. First, open admin, and under data collection and modification, choose data deletion request. If you are not seeing this option, make sure you have the editor role so you can make these changes in your Google Analytics property. Next, choose schedule data deletion request. Choose the type of data you want to delete. For this example, we'll choose delete selected registered parameters on selected events. Next, select the start and end dates, which will set the date range for the data that will be deleted. Depending on the type of data deletion you choose, there might be further information you'll need to provide. For this example, we'll choose the custom event and the associated parameters that are collecting the information we want to delete. Once all information is filled in, click Schedule Requests and Confirm Deletion. After you submit the deletion request, editor role users are notified of the request via email, and any editor can cancel the request within 7 days from the time it was created by clicking into the request in the table and choosing Cancel Deletion. Starting during that 7-day grace period, your reports and analysis will omit the requested data as though it were already deleted, so you can preview the outcome and confirm that it's what you expect. Then the request can take between 7 and 63 days to be processed, depending on the amount of data to be deleted. You can also use the Data Deletion API to create and manage these deletion requests. Also, note that Google Analytics doesn't log or store individual IP addresses, so you don't need to request this data be deleted as it is not collected or stored. Now that we've covered data deletion, let's talk about consent mode. Consent mode with Google Analytics lets you communicate your user's cookie or app identifier consent status to Google. Tags adjust their behavior and respect users' choices, which allows users to choose what data is collected. It is designed to help website owners comply with privacy regulations such as the General Data Protection Regulation, or GDPR in the European Union. Regulations like this require businesses to ask user permission before collecting specific types of data. So this is why many websites and apps have a banner or pop-up that asks the user to check or uncheck certain terms. Consent mode allows website owners to adjust how Google tags behave based on a user's consent status for data processing. These tag settings are available for anyone using the Google Tag and Google Tag Manager. With consent mode, when consent is granted by a user, the associated measurement functions will be processed with their default behaviors. However, when consent is denied by the user, the associated measurement functions will adjust their behavior accordingly. Then, analytics uses Google's AI to fill in the gaps in the data. The result is a data set that represents an accurate picture of website and app performance, all while knowing that the technology providing these results is built in an adaptive, privacy-centric way that respects users' choices and privacy. Along with consent mode, analytics uses Google's AI in other areas to better measure user journeys. By now, you'll be aware that user behavior is changing. When people decline analytics cookie storage or switch from one device to another, there's likely to be some gaps in the data that's being collected. This is why Google Analytics uses Google's AI and machine learning capabilities to model user journeys in the absence of observable data. Modeling generally refers to the process of using machine learning algorithms to analyze existing data and make predictions about future or missing data. Google Analytics incorporates machine learning models to provide more advanced insights into user behavior and to help businesses understand, predict, and optimize their online performance. It can also use modeling to fill in the gaps for app and web traffic where analytics cookie consent was denied using behavioral modeling, or to accurately attribute missing events to appropriate sources based on trends learned from observable data using conversion modeling. Increased privacy thresholds require new ways to accurately measure events and understand the impact of each channel, which is essential for businesses to optimize and get the most out of digital advertising spend. As we've seen, Google Analytics can help accomplish this with data deletion, consent mode, and modeling capabilities.